energy and second objects which are moving or the object which express movement receives that kinetic energy. Okay, for example, storing of water in a dam. Okay, storing of water in a dam is example for potential energy, because storing of water in a dam is at rest position. If you open the door of dam, what happen? Water ready to move. Okay, but it is in rest position, so he says that storing of water in a dam is example of potential energy. If you open the doors of dam, what happens? Water starts flowing. Water flowing means we says that water is falling or water is moving. It means the object which are in motion or the object which is moving, we says that kinetic energy. Here the combination of potential energy as well as kinetic energy, we says that mechanical energy. And third one is heat energy.
Get heat. Okay. About wind energy. In ancient time, people used to make boats and ships sail on the ocean with the help of wind. Next one, windmill. What's this? We say windmill. Here, the fan-like structure, we says wind fan. Three turbines are there in a single fan. Number of fans arranged, we says that windmill. Windmill means windmill rotate due to the fast movement of wind. The turbines rotate due to this wind energy produced electricity. See the wind fan having three turbines. Because of air, the turbines are the wings of fan start moving. Means air energy or wind energy is converted into electrical energy. Let's see about wind energy. In ancient time, people used to make boats and ships sail on the ocean with the help of wind. Next one, windmill. What's this? We say windmill. Here, the fan-like structure, we says wind fan. Three turbines are there in a single fan. Number of fans arranged, we says that windmill. Windmill means windmill rotate due to the fast movement of wind. The turbines rotate due to this wind energy produced electricity. See the wind fan having three turbines. Because of air, the turbines are the wings of fan start moving. Means air energy or wind energy is converted into electrical energy. Next one question is, how is wind used to produce electricity? Answer, windmills rotate due to the fast movement of wind. Turbines rotating due to this wind energy produced electricity. Okay, next question. Write about any work done by wind energy. Answer. First point, production of electricity from wind. We know that when air is moving, the time the turbine starts moving, means air energy or wind energy is converted into electrical energy. Let's see second point. People used to make boat and ships to move on the ocean with the help of wind. This is about wind energy. Next, see the picture, students. Stored energy of water. What you observe on picture? Flowing of water. Means we says that dam, we can saw, fan, homes. Okay, let's see students. Here, stored water energy or stored energy of water means we know that mechanical energy. Mechanical energy means the energy is a combination of potential energy as well as kinetic energy. We know that here the storing of water in a dam is example for potential energy, and the moving water or falling of water is example for kinetic energy. Here kinetic energy as well as potential energy, we says that mechanical energy. Okay, mechanical energy means combination of potential and kinetic energy. In stored energy of water, what kind of energy is? Yes? See students, in order to use water as a source of energy, a dam has to be built across a river and water must be stored in it. Stored water means potential energy. Stored water is allowed to flow from higher level to fall on turbines. Turbines, due to the force exerted by running water, turbines rotate fast and produce electricity. Here it is a turbine. These are called hydroelectric power generating station. From water we are generating electricity. We say that hydroelectric power generating station. See, write the names of dams you know and put right mark to the ones you have visited. Okay, tell me the name of dams. Let's see with the help of questions. List the names of dams you know or which you have visited. Answer, the name here is our names of dams. If you are visited those dams, put the right mark. Answer is Kabini Dam, Almaty Dam. These are the dams. Next, see the question. List the dams built across rivers and hydroelectric power generating station in Karnataka. We already know what actually hydroelectric power generating station. Hydroelectric power generating station means production of electricity with the help of water. We says that hydroelectric power generating station. See, the answer is Almaty, Kibni Dam, Mahatma Gandhi, Tail Race, Varahi. These are the names of dams which built across rivers and hydroelectric power generating stations in Karnataka. Next, define a hydroelectric power generating station. Here you need to write the meaning of hydroelectric power generating station. Let's see the answer. The running water hits the turbines with great force, which in turn produces electricity. Such a power station is called hydroelectric power generating station. Let's remove. See students, energy produced by the ocean tides is called tidal or tidal energy. Okay, here is also in ocean we saw water. From those that tides we can convert tides into energy form. That type of energy we says that tidal energy or tidal energy. What you mean by tidal energy? Energy produced by the ocean tides is called tidal energy. Next, see students, electrical energy. What you mean by electrical energy and why we are using electrical energy? See, nowadays most of our daily work is begin easily done by the help of electricity. It is possible to do more work in less time using electricity. Why we are using electrical appliances or electrical energy? Because with the help of electrical energy we can do our work in a less period of time. More work in a less period of time with the help of electricity or electrical energy. So we are using electrical energy to ease our daily works. See students, here work done using electrical appliances in your home. In page number 173, you need to complete the activity which is given, electrical appliances and what are the work. Which electrical appliance is it? It is refrigerator. For working of refrigerator, we need electrical energy, the appliance which is used in our homes, which work with the help of electricity. See next one, air conditioner. For air conditioner also use electrical energy. Without electricity, air conditioner not work. Next is coffee maker. For coffee making, we need energy or fuel. If we make coffee on stove, we need fuel. But it is an electrical coffee maker, so that we need electrical energy to make coffee. Next one is washing machine. Washing machine, why we use? We use to wash clothes. But the washing machine run with the help of electricity. We says that washing machine is also run with the help of electrical energy. Next one is bulb. Bulb are electrical bulb. For glowing of bulb, we need electricity. Next, fluorescent lamp or tube light. Generally, we are using tube light in homes. The alternate name of tube light is fluorescent lamp. This is also work on the basis of electricity. Next one is iron box. In earlier days, people use metal iron box, in that they use coal. After that, they start ironing the cloths. But nowadays, everything is electrical. So iron box is also electrical. Electrical iron box work with the help of electricity. Next one is microwave oven. This is also work with electricity. Next one is TV. What is the full form of TV? TV is nothing but television. Okay. For working of television or for switch on TV, what we need? We need electricity. Let's see, what's this? It's a computer. Computer also work. Yes, tell me. Computer also work with the help of electrical energy. See students, nowadays we are using so many electrical appliances. So we need more and more electrical energy. From where we get electrical energy? We get electrical energy in the form of mechanical energy, heat energy, or with the help of air we can produce electrical energy. With the help of solar energy, we can convert solar energy into electrical energy. Next one is bioenergy. What do you mean by bioenergy? Yes, bioenergy is also one kind of energy. The gas produced by decaying of agricultural waste. The gas which produced by decaying of agricultural waste, plant residues, animal dungs, etc. in the absence of air is called biogas. How biogas is produced? Biogas is produced by decaying agricultural waste, plant residues, animal dung. These are in the absence of air. Okay. In the absence of air only biogas produced. Okay. Biogas is also one kind of energy. It is used for cooking purpose also. Bioenergy also used for cooking purpose. The energy available from biogas can be converted into electricity and may be used for many works. Okay. Bioenergy obtained from agricultural waste helps human being to maintain healthy environment, because we know that with waste materials or with plant residues, animal dung, we can make biogas. If we use biogas, it converted into electrical energy or another kind of fuel energy. If we do this bioenergy or if we make bioenergy, we can easily cleanly maintain our environment or we can maintain our healthy environment. Okay, let's see students. Next is chemical energy. What is chemical energy? See, energy that is available for release from chemical reaction, we says that chemical energy. What do you mean by chemical energy? Whatever the energy which is produced with the help of chemicals, we says that chemical energy. Generally, see, what's this? It is an electrical cell. Chemical energy is produced by the chemical reaction that takes place in the substance. Here, substance is electric cell. We know that electric cell have two terminals. One is positive terminal and another one is negative terminal. On electric cell, the cap like structure indicate that positive terminal. Okay, the base which is negative terminal. Inside the electric cell, there is a chemical. Inside the electric cell, using chemicals, from chemical reaction in electric cell, it produces electricity. If the chemical reaction takes place inside the electric cell, it produces electricity when the circuit is closed. See the connection. Connection of electric cell with electric bulb is closed. It means for chemicals are inside the electric cell, it reacts each other. Because of that chemical reaction, electricity is produced in the form of electric bulb glow. Okay, dear students, today in this class we learned about types of energy, different form of energy. In that we already learned about muscular energy, mechanical energy, heat energy, solar energy, and we also learned wind energy, water stored energy, electrical energy, bioenergy and chemical energy. So because of that conversion of energy into another form, the topic name is amazing energy. I hope you understood the class and enjoy the class. I hope you learn class with fun. In next class we continue the topic amazing energy. I hope you understood better. Thank you.